Okay, good morning to everybody. My name is Giuseppe Vitalesi, and I'm going to present this work on mechanical characterization of the behavior of a we are going to talk about the mechanical behavior of a green sandwich. By green, we mean that we use natural fibers, flux, reinforced polymer as the facings of the sandwich, and a cork, so another natural source material, cork core. Okay, this is the brief outline of my talk. I will first of all present the research team and explain why it's a sailing team. Then I will describe the proposed sandwich concept. I will then describe the characterization of skin and cores alone, and then the flexural properties of the sandwich by introducing the methods we used and also the results. Okay, this activity actually was aimed at the manufacturing in-house of a sailing dinghy, sailing boat, which participates in this competition. It's called Mille Una Vela Cup. It's a competition joined by many Italian universities to make regattas around the Mediterranean Sea with boats that are actually designed and manufactured by students and staff, members of staff. So basically the idea is also to try to implement some new ideas, some new concepts in these kind of sailing boats. And we propose to make the hull the boat by using this cork material as the core of the sandwich, and flux fibers, and everything was then assembled by a vacuum bag system, and resin infusion as well. So this is the final result from the ground. Okay, so basically I already mentioned what is the sandwich concept we have considered. We have some pictures, and the skins use flux and an epoxy matrix. And epoxy maybe at this moment is still the less natural material, but we are thinking to evolve towards some natural epoxy in the future. This is a picture of the fabric, the flux fabric. It's a quasi unidimensional fabric and has got this heavier weight, 180 grams per square meter. And the properties of flux are not that far away from the glass, for instance, if you see on this table down here. Density is a little bit lighter. Young modulus is not so far, tensile properties are still okay, and so this makes this material one of the best natural fibers for structural application, actually. Also the cost is reasonable. What about the cork material? The core material is an agglomerated cork core, so it's taken from cork. And it comes with different densities according to how dense you agglomerate these cork particles. And there are some very good features of this core material, something like a good vibration damping, a good damage tolerance to impact loads, crashworthy performances, good drappability, good thermal and acoustic isolation. All these kind of features make this a very good candidate for sandwiches. For the characterization purposes, we manufactured three panels, and we used three different techniques. We wanted to compare the performances of these three techniques. So we used the hand layer, vacuum bagging, and resin infusion. And each of the panel manufactured contained one end of the panel with a sandwich assembly, and the other end of the panel with a monolithic assembly. So we could cut samples for the skin characterization, for sandwich characterization from the same manufactured panel. This is a schematic of the manufacturing. This is some picture taken from the manufacturing of the panels, so we have a simple hand layout. By hand layout I mean we do not apply any pressure to consolidate the material. By vacuum bag we impregnate the material, and then we apply the vacuum pressure, and then vacuum infusion we assemble the dry material, and then we wet by vacuum assisted resin infusion. Okay, the first thing we measured after we manufactured our samples was the fiber volume fraction. And we found out it was expected that the Indelayat was the one with a lower fiber fraction, 39%, while the vacuum bag reached a higher fiber fraction because there is more resin taken out from the aerial layer, the breather, so we are able to reach higher fiber fraction, fiber volume fraction. What is interesting here is to analyze the amount of resin that is soaked by the cork core. The cork core has a kind of a porous consistency, so there is a lot of resin flowing inside the cork. And after we manufactured the panels, we found out that the hand layup increased its weight, the core increased the weight by 33%. The resin infusion by 122%, the vacuum bag by 65%. So the one that took more resin was the resin infusion, because probably the resin traveled through the sandwich and there is more resin absorbed by the cork core. So we started to make our tests. We first tested the tensile behavior of the skins. We used a normal tensile test with an extensometer to measure the deformation. And the most peculiar outcome from this testing is that the flux fibers exhibit a sort of knee and change of slope, yes. And this is quite dramatic, actually, because as you can see the figures here, you go from around 20 gigapascal to almost 10 gigapascal. And the other thing is that this kind of change of slope occurs very early in the stress curve. So we also inquired in the literature what is the origin of this behavior, and it seems that most convincing explanation is the presence of some defects on the flux fiber. These are called kink bands, which are produced when the fiber is mechanically taken out from the stem of the plant. So it seems to be quite unavoidable to end up with these kind of defects. And there is a nice work from these guys which correlates this behavior with these defects in the fibers. Then we tested also the torque, the sandwich in a flatwise compression direction. Here you can see some curves. We also made some sort of a low cycle fatigue to see what was the ability of the material to recover the deformation. But the most important figure here is the Young modulus in compression. And we found out that the hand layup had half the value than the vacuum bag resin infusion. And this is because the vacuum bag resin infusion absorbed a lot of resin. So this resin is reinforcing the cork stiffness in flatwise compression by quite a lot. Let's move now to the sandwich flexural properties of this material. We decided to use to perform a sandwich test with many different span lengths. And we decided to do that because we wanted to decouple the flexural term and the shear term of deformation. If you want to decouple these two terms, you have to perform more than one flexural test and then combine the different slopes of the curves to decouple these. This is actually done in this way. You see that the flexural term and the shear terms are given by these quantities. By rearranging these quantities, you can have a linear interpolation of the experimental data, and the slope of this linear interpolation is related with the flexural stiffness, B. And the intercept is correlated with the shear stiffness U. So it's quite simple the way you decouple these two elastic components. But this is known in the literature. What we implemented in this work is the possibility to consider also the local indentation, especially with this kind of cork materials that are very low stiffness cores. Especially the end layup assembly has only 16 megapascal of Young modulus. There is a probability that you develop local indentation. So we basically use this equation that comes from considering a beam resting on a one-parameter fully baked Winkler foundation. This solution gives the indentation, the local indentation, as a function of P and delta, and there is the flexural stiffness of the skin involved, and this parameter, lambda, that is related to the Young modulus of the core and the geometry of the sandwich. By adding this term in our expression of delta, in our formula of the total displacement, and by considering that here we have a full indentation, here we have a half indentation because the load here and here is half the load in the mid-center, we can add this new term in the equation. And then when we rearrange to make our linear correlation, we just put this term in the first part of the equation, and we can still perform a linear correlation. So what is the result of this procedure? Let's go through this. When we apply the new equation that we have proposed, the equation changes, the linear interpolation changes a little bit, not so much, but just a little bit. Here you can compare the results. The green results are obtained with the proposed formulation. The red results with the traditional formulation. And you can see already that the correlation coefficient is improving a little bit, even if it was already very good with the traditional, but it's improving. But most of all, what we found out is a great influence on the shear rigidity. The red one is with a traditional term that doesn't account for indentation. So indentation is very important to consider the shear rigidity of the sandwich. And also, we found out that the result with the proposed methodology is much closer to this result that is actually calculated by considering the distribution of masses in the cross-section of the sandwich. So this is a sort of alternative way to calculate the same thing and to have a comparison with what we propose. And as you can see, the flexural stiffness is not changing much, but with a new, by taking into account the indentation, it's improved compared to the other procedure. Okay, a final look at the strength behavior of the sandwich. It doesn't move.
He's going to summarize by voice what is going to say after.
Yes, okay. The quantity of resin absorbed by the core to core influence a lot the strength properties of this sandwich. And in the end, the manufacturer of this sandwich assembly influenced a lot the characteristics because of this resin getting inside the core. And that's all. I mean, in this we basically, just to summarize, have proposed a new procedure to interpolate the data and decouple the effect of indentation, flexural and shear rigidity. And this is, we think, good whenever you have soft cores that imitate easily. And the other thing is that the boat didn't sink.
Okay. So that's very important. And thank you very much.